So guys, in today's video, we are getting the opportunity to have a look at Any.DO again. Obviously, I reviewed it, I think, back in 2016, so it's been a fair while that we've reviewed it here on the channel. But I want to take another look because they've made a few visual changes with the applications, and also they've added a lot more list building experiences inside it. So we're gonna take a look. So guys, before we dive in, a few facts about Any.DO. It's been around since 2011, so it actually has been in the space. It's one of those applications that a lot of people see on the App Store, but don't particularly go with it because of some of the more predominant options at the moment. But it does have a really good Google Play Store rating and App Store rating for consistency. I think it's got like 4.5 on the Google Play App Store with over 300,000 user ratings. It has well over 10 million installs alone on Android, and it does provide a pretty fluid experience. Some of the platforms is available on Android, iOS, Google Home, Alexa, Windows, Chrome, Slack, desktop, and Mac too, which is pretty impressive. So I'm gonna be taking a look and the resource, jumping on the laptop and diving a little more in. If you're brand new to this YouTube channel, feel free to subscribe. And if you would like to check out all of the Skillshare courses below, you get 2 months free Skillshare with that too. So let's dive into Any.DO, guys. So here we are with Any.DO for iOS. And what I wanted to do is explore the application, demo some of the functions and features, and then share some of my thoughts and opinions on it. Definitely, I think this application works very well, and I think it's one of those applications that I need to continue to recommend for those who are looking for really simple list managers. As you can see here, Any.DO really focuses on two core parts, and that's tasks and calendar. So as you can see on this left-hand side, tasks allows you to see all of your activities for today, tomorrow, upcoming, and someday, and you can start adding them straight away from here. But if I go in the top left-hand corner, I can access something called My Lists, and essentially I can see all of the lists that I've created in the past. Now, of course, you can click into one of them and start adding away, essentially start creating them. And of course, once you add them to that list, obviously they'll start to organize into a chronological order, or you can sort them up in the top right-hand corner. So let's start adding some. Okay, I've got some personal tasks. Let's say I need to buy some new shoes, which I actually do need to do. And I want to do it tomorrow because I'm in town tomorrow. I'm gonna add that one straight there. You can see it's come up as Saturday at 9 a.m. I'm gonna add a few more as well. I'm gonna also say pick up new shampoo because that's definitely on my list. And again, I'm gonna say tomorrow too. Now you can see that one's also come up on my list. So let's add a few more. Okay, I've added two more than I've actually had in my brain. But you can see that this list is starting to build up. And as you can imagine, if I wanted to go back, you can see that there. And if I go back to all tasks, it's coordinated it into this really simple list. And as you can see, if I want to, I can add any other items to it. It'll give you a couple of the prompts as you straight away, and you can also add it via voice, which is quite easy. So it's a really simple list manager at heart. If I want to, I can click into these items, I can add a tag, I can move it to another list from here. I can also add reminders as well. So I can add repeat tasks, location reminders. I believe that's locked under premium, although we'll discuss that near the end. And you can add any other recurring items. So as you can see, it's ideal. I've got obviously my tasks start piling up there, and I can start seeing them inside of my calendar function. So I can see them alongside my calendar application. As you can see, this is my view for my calendar. If I want to, I can hide that away and I can start visualizing what I've got ahead. So let's say I'm seeing obviously dinner tomorrow night. There we go. And as I can see, I can open it up and see all of the details there. And if I want to, I can scrubble it away as well as edit it. So the application is really simple in function. They've had a design upgrade, I'd say. As you can see, this looks a lot smarter. And if I want to edit the item, it comes up really beautifully here, which is something they didn't have before. Now, they've recently added this new grocery list function, which is quite impressive. So for example, if I go to this top left-hand corner, hit the grocery list, and you can create as many grocery lists as you want, then what you can start doing is adding grocery items. So for example, if I added bananas, it automatically sorts it into there. So I actually do need eggs. What else do I need? I need, actually probably need some toothpaste. We picked up tea bags the other day, so probably just more beef mince. And that's probably it for this weekend. So if I go back to the grocery list, you can see here it's organized it into different sections, which is quite nice. So for example, if I add more apples and I go back to this list, I'm really messy with my usage. You can see that it's coordinated it really neatly there. And it's also really easy. You can share the list straight away. So for example, if I wanted to share this with my wife, I can, and I can also start from scratch, edit the list name, and paste from a clipboard too. So if you had some existing ones there, or you want to export it, it's quite easy to do so. And that's really nice addition, especially for those people that don't really want an intense list manager. So of course, it's got a few functions, particularly in the top right hand corner, you can see that it's got Any.DO tips and notifications, but there is a function called Plan My Day, but it's originally called Any.DO Moments. If I click Plan My Day, you can see Any.DO Moments appears. So you can see here, I've got a few items, Plan My Day. Once I click into it, it only works for when you've got it for the today. So for example, it'll bring up your item and it'll say, okay, cool, Bob. Will you still be doing it today, later, or have you done it? Okay, I've actually called Bob. Brilliant, Bob's called. And okay, so I need to pay my driving instructor. I actually need to do it later, but it doesn't have any of the times that I want to. Let's say I'm gonna pay him tomorrow, and I'm actually gonna do this one today too. So you can actually have a set time for it. So for example, I wanna say, actually, I'm gonna pay off at 4 p.m. So there we go, apparently I've made it happen. And you can see here that it's ticked off the call for Bob and organized that for 4 p.m. Sorry. So you've obviously got a view of what's happening. Now, Any.DO also have an assistant, which I actually don't have available in my layout, but it's something they're working on. It's something I'm gonna sign up to and do a separate tutorial on. So a little bit more about the premium functions. The premium is set at $2.99 a month, but you have to pay annually for that. In my head, I can roughly work that out about $36 per year, I think it is. It should be. And you can also do a host of things in that premium. So the premium functions include color tags, location-based reminders, recurring reminders, themes, collabs, that's more collaborating, unlimited. I'm not sure what the limit is on a free account, but I think it's pretty healthy. And attachments unlimited too. Now this is the settings page as well. If I want to, I can edit all the details. I do have a premium account and that's why I have access to all these themes and stuff. And where you want your home screen to come up on, etc., etc. And all of the regular stuff you'd get, all very small details here. But as you can see, this application is really designed as your basic list manager. My recommendation is for those who are looking for a dead simple one, my recommendation is Any.DO. Obviously, there are countless alternatives out there, but Any.DO is available on lots of different platforms. It's highly recommended. It's got a good user base, and they obviously have a premium experience. So chances are this is going to be around for at least a little bit more. They've been around 8 years already. So it's really great to see this application as a solution. Anyway, guys, hopefully that gave you a nice overview of Any.DO. Of course, it's very simplistic, but if it's something that you might want to scale down to or even pick up, then this could be a good application for you. Anyway, guys, thank you for stopping by today. I hope you enjoyed today's feature. I'll be doing some more revisited features very soon. I've already got a Miller note on my list for the next one. Anyway, guys, thank you very much. I will see you guys very, very soon.